Chapter 0, next we are going to study about reproduction in bacteria. Now, as we have already studied when studying the gender characteristics of bacteria,
there are both asexual reproduction as well as sexual reproduction seen in bacteria. So mostly the bacteria, they reproduce asexually. Asexually reproduction is done by binary fission, conidia and endospore formation. In this also the most common among them is binary fission, okay, and binary fission, it takes place during favorable condition. Okay, so first let's study about binary fission. Under favorable condition, the cell divides into two daughter cells. Okay, so here you can see the diagram figure 1.11a. So here you can see one bacterial cell. Okay, this is a mature bacterial cell. After this mature bacterial cell, first the nuclear material, the genetic material, DNA, it divides. Okay, it produces a replica of it. It divides into two. After the division of this nuclear material, the constriction is followed in the cell wall. That is, both the edges of the cell, they come and meet in the center, forming a wall in the center between the two cells. Okay, as a result, what will happen? One single cell divides into two daughter cells. Okay, one single bacterial cell divides into two daughter cells. This is called as binary fission. So the nuclear material divides first and is followed by the formation of a simple median. Median means in the partition constriction, which finally results in the separation of the two cells. So this is about the binary fission. Next, so as we have studied in bacteria, the most common type of asexual reproduction is binary fission. Next we are going to study is endospore formation. As we studied, binary fission takes place only in the presence of favorable condition. When the situation is suitable, then only the binary fission will take place. If the external environmental condition or other conditions, they are unsuitable, then endospore formation will take place. So during unfavorable condition, bacteria produce endospores. So endospores, they are produced in some species like Bacillus, Megatherium, Bacillus, Tertius and Clostridium tetanum. So here you can see in the diagram, in the B diagram, you can see a bacterial cell. Inside a bacterial cell, during unfavorable condition, the entire cell content will constrict and they will form a wall around it. Okay, a thick wall it will form around itself, around the cell content. This condition is called as the endospore. Okay, this is called as the endospore. The entire cell content of the bacteria, they will condense and they will form a thick wall around it. This condition is called as endospore. This structure is called as endospore. So here endospores, they are thick-walled resting spores. Okay, endospores, they are also called as the resting spores. So during favorable condition, when they get the suitable condition returns, what will happen? They will germinate. That is, the thick wall of the endospore will rupture and they will germinate and form the bacteria. Is it clear for you? So here we have studied two types of asexual reproduction in bacteria. One is the binary fission and the other one is the endospore formation. Binary fission takes place during the favorable condition and endospore formation will take place during the unfavorable condition. Next, you are going to study about the sexual reproduction in bacteria. Now, as we know, bacteria is a unicellular organism. Okay, there is no formation of gametes and no fusion of gametes. Okay, gamete fusion or the formation of gametes and the fusion of gametes does not take place. So here we can say the sexual reproduction in bacteria, they are not the true sexual reproduction. So typical sexual reproduction involving the formation and fusion of gamete is absent in bacteria. Here what is happening? Only the transfer of the genetic material is taking place. The bacteria which is having a particular gene, a copy of it is being transferred to the next bacteria. So here this type of reproduction, this type of sharing of the gene, this is considered as sexual reproduction. This sexual reproduction is actually not a true sexual reproduction, but it is a gene recombination. So, however, gene recombination can occur in bacteria by three different methods. So, first method is conjugation, second is transformation, third is transduction. So, first one we study conjugation.
So, J. Lederberg and Edward L. Patton demonstrated conjugation in E. coli in the year 1946. In this method of gene transfer, as we have studied,
sexual reproduction in bacteria is not the formation and fusion of gametes. It's only a gene recombination. So, in this method also, gene transfer from one cell, the cell which is giving the gene is called the donor cell, and the one which is receiving is called as the recipient. In this method of gene transfer, the donor cell gets attached to the recipient cell with the help of pili. While studying about the ultrastructure of the bacteria, in that we have studied what are pili. They are also the small hair-like structures which originates from the cell wall, and this pili is meant for attachment. So here also the two bacterial cells, the one which is having the gene, that is called as the donor cell, and the one which is not having the, which is going to receive the gene, that is called as the recipient. These two, donor and the recipient, they join together with the help of a pili. Okay, the pilus grows in size and forms a conjugation tube. So this pile, after the attachment, it will form a tube like structure which connects both the cell, the donor and the recipient, and that is called as the conjugation tube. The plasmid of the donor cell, plasmid, I think all of you remember, it is the extra chromosomal circular DNA which is found in the bacteria. The plasmid of the donor cell, which has the fertility factor, we have already studied the plasmids, they have fertility factors, so they undergo replication. So the plasmid of the donor cell, which has the fertility factor, they will undergo replication. Replication means it will produce a copy exactly like the previous one, and only one strand of the DNA is transferred to the recipient cell through the conjugation tube. After producing a copy, what will happen? One strand will be transferred to the recipient cell through this conjugation tube. The recipient completes the structure of double-stranded. Now, both the DNA, the donor and the recipient, they have only single strand of DNA. So, both the donor and the recipient will form another copy. Okay. It will form the another copy of that DNA, or it will form a complete strand, and that is, they will synthesize the strand that is complement to the strand which they have acquired from the donor. So here you can see the diagrammatic representation. So here figure 1.12, conjugation. Here you can see F plus cell, okay, that is the donor cell. F minus cell, that is the recipient cell. So here you can see the F plus cell or the donor cell, they have the plasmid. In the plasmid, they have the fertility factor. Okay, as we have studied already, in the bacterial cell, in the center of the cell, there is a genetic material. Chromosome is present there, that is also circular. Apart from that, in the bacteria, there are extra chromosomal DNA, that is called the plasmid, and in the plasmid, they carry the fertility factor. So here the F plus cell or the donor cell, they have the fertility plasmid is present there, whereas the F minus cell, they do not have the plasmid. So here what will happen, this F plus cell, the pili of the F plus cell will attach with the recipient cell with the help of the pilus. So both the donor and the recipient, F plus cell and the F minus cell, will join with the help of the pili, and this pili will grow and develop into a conjugation tube. Okay, so here you can see in the diagram. Next, what will happen, this plasmid, okay, it will produce a copy, one copy of this plasmid through this conjugation tube will be transferred to the another bacteria which is not having. The third diagram you can see a strand of plasmid DNA strand is transferred to the another bacteria which is not having that plasmid. Next, after that, both the strands, now both the bacteria, only one strand of DNA is present. So what will happen? Both will synthesize its complementary strand. Okay, both will synthesize its complementary strand and it will form a complete DNA, complete circular DNA or complete plasmid will be formed between the two and the both will be separated out. So here what will happen, again the gene transfer is taking place. Okay, the gene for fertility factor which is present in the plasmid is being taking place. So this is called as a conjugation. Okay, a conjugation, it is said to be the sexual reproduction in bacteria. As we already studied, no true sexual reproduction takes place in the bacteria. Next is sexual reproduction or the gene recombination is transformation. So transfer of DNA from one bacterium to another is called as transformation. Okay, so transfer of DNA from one bacterium to another is called as transformation. In 1928, the bacteriologist Frederick Griffith demonstrated transformation in mice using Diplococcus pneumonia. So here, Frederick Griffith and bacteriologist, he studied about the transformation by his famous mice experiment. So he found that in the mice with the help of a pneumonia-causing strain, Diplococcus pneumonia. Two strains of this bacteria, okay, Diplococcus pneumonia, Diplococcus as we studied, it's a bacteria, so causing the pneumonia, so Diplococcus pneumonia, this strain, there are two strains of this bacteria. One strain, it produces smooth colonies. When they are cultured, they produce the smooth colonies. They are virulent. Virulent means very poisonous in nature, disease causing in nature. So one strain produces smooth colonies and are virulent, so it is highly contagious, highly disease causing. Okay, so this virulent type, they produce smooth colonies, so they are called as S type. Okay, this strand of this strain of Diplococcus pneumonia, it was called as S type. Now in addition, another strain produced rough colonies and they were called as A virulent. A virulent means they are not so poisonous, they are not so harmful. So here in Diplococcus pneumonia, they found two strains of bacteria. One is producing the smooth colony and that is the virulent type and called as the S type. And the another one was called to be the producing rough colonies and they were A virulent and they were called as the R type. When the S type of cells were injected into the mouse, so here one by one he performed the experiment, only the S type cell, as we know, it is virulent type. So when this S type cells was injected inside the mouse died. Second condition, second mice, what he did, the R type of cells was injected, but the mouse survived. So as we studied, R type is A virulent type. So when this R type of strain was injected inside the mouse survived. So first condition, S type was injected, the mouse died. Second condition, the R type of strain was injected, the mouse survived. Third, he injected heat-killed S type cells. So third condition, what he did, he gave the heat treatment to the S type of cells and that heat-treated S type of cells was injected inside the mouse. The mouse did not die. Okay, so third condition, he gave the heat treatment and then this heat treated S type cells was injected inside the mouse, so mouse did not die. Fourth, what he did, fourth condition, the mixture of heat killed S type cells and the R type cells were injected into the mouse. So what he did in the fourth experiment, he took the heat treated S type cells and he mixed this with the R type cells. No heat treatment is given to the R type. R type is as it is. So heat treated S type cells were mixed with the R type cells and they were in this mixture was injected inside the mouse. Okay. So to his observation, the mouse died. Okay. So from this he concluded the A virulent rough strain of Diplococcus had been transformed into S type cells. As we know, R type cells, they are A virulent, they cannot kill the organism. Okay, they are not so dangerous. But when it was mixed with the S-type cells, this S-type cells has transformed this R-type cells. As a result, the mouse died. Okay, the hereditary material of heat-killed S-type cells has transformed R-type cells into virulent smooth strains. Thus, the phenomenon of changing the character of one strain by transferring the another. So here you can see, by transforming the DNA of another strain into the former is called as transformation. So here you can see the experiment here. So the first one, what is it? R strain we have studied, it is what? A virulent. So when this R strain cells was injected inside the mouse alive. Next, S strain we have studied, it is virulent. So this S strain, when it was injected inside the mouse dies. Third, what he did, he gave the heat treatment to the S strain, and that heat treated, heat killed S strains was injected inside the mouse was alive. In the fourth condition, what he did, the R strain and the heat killed S strain, they both injected inside the mouse, so mouse died. So here what has happened, the S type of cells has transformed the R type of cells. This is called as transformation. Okay, so here thus the phenomenon of changing the character of one strain by transferring the DNA of another strain into the former is called as transformation. Next, we are going to study about transduction. Zinder and Lederberg discovered transduction in Salmonella typhimurium. Phage mediated DNA transfer. Phage means bacteriophage. Mediated with the help of the bacteriophage, the DNA is transferred, is called as transduction. So transduction, with the help of any mediator, we are transferring the gene. That is called as transduction. So phage mediated DNA transfer is called transduction. So transduction is of two types: generalized transduction and specialized or restricted transduction. So generalized transduction, the ability of a bacteriophage to carry the genetic material of any region of bacterial DNA is called as generalized transduction. So here no particular area is fixed here. Generally, it is inserted with the help of bacteriophage. The DNA is inserted inside the cell. Then it is called as generalized transduction. Specialized or restricted transduction, the ability of the bacteriophage to carry only a specific region of the bacterial DNA is called as specialized or restricted transduction. Here you can see, with the help of the phage, in the first diagram you can see the phage is outside the bacterial cell, the bacterial chromosome is marked there. Next, what is done, the phage DNA is entering inside the bacterial cell. Next, so here two types of transformation can take, two types of transfer of gene is taking place, either it is generalized or it is specialized. So in the first one, we'll see the phage DNA enters, and only to one of the segment of the DNA, this phage DNA is getting added up. Okay, after that, what will happen, they will synthesize their own protein components, as we already studied in the virus, the lytic and the lysogenic cycle we have studied. Only the genetic material of the phage will enter inside the bacterial cell, and the remaining protein coat will remain outside the cell. So after the entering of the genetic material, this virulent phage, what will happen, they will develop their own protein coat, and they will synthesize the protein, they assemble themselves, they will mature, and numerous bacteriophage they are produced. So here, and they are released by the rupture. So this is the virulent phage. Next is what, the specialized. So here what is happening, the phage DNA enters, it becomes the part of the bacterial chromosome. Now all the particles, all the phages inside, they will have the copy of it, then it is called as specialized. So all the DNAs will have that, all the phages will have both the bacterial DNA as well as the phage DNA, then it is called as the specialized transduction. So here, With this, we conclude the reproduction. Okay, so here we have studied two types of reproduction: asexual reproduction, mostly by binary fission during favorable condition, and during unfavorable condition, endosphore formation. Next, we have studied about the sexual reproduction. We have studied no true sexual reproduction takes place in bacteria because there is no formation of gamete and no fusion of gamete. Here only the gene transfer is taking place. So this gene transfer can take place in three ways. First one is conjugation, next one is transformation, and third one is the transduction. So with this, we complete the reproduction in bacteria.